Because I can tell you, from the day that little girl was born, she was a survivor. She was a fighter.
If I die young, bury me inside, lay me down.
She was born April 18th, 1998, up in St. Albert. And that day, we knew. She was wise beyond her years. I don't know, I have so many words and it's so hard to say.
Life ain't always what you think it ought to be, you know. Ain't even gray, but she buries her baby. The shot.
You know, no matter what came her way, no matter what challenges came her way, she was brave, she was strong, she just had an incredible will to live that just astounded people. I think her friends were, I think her friends just feel blessed to have had her be a part of their life, because she had only a few really good friends, and they knew her best out of anyone. And she, I don't know, I think they just loved her.
She was incredibly caring, like the kindest heart of anyone. She loved to care for anything she could find. She was never mean to anyone. She just had a heart of gold, really.
Kristin was my friend since I was 6 or 7 years old, and we were really, really close, and she was like the nicest person ever, and she always found a way to help people.
Kristin was by no means a girly girl, but she cleaned up pretty good when she put on a pretty dress. She could be just absolutely stunning when she'd let us fix her up a little bit. She was beautiful in dresses. Now, Kristin just had the most beautiful smile, the most beautiful eyes. She had very wise, beautiful eyes. And she liked to, she didn't do much with her hair, but she liked to tie it up with a ribbon. She'd get ribbon at Christmas time and save it to tie up her hair with. Kristin loved to play piano too. She took lessons for years. She was a perfectionist. When she was learning a song, it had to be just perfect. She could even play Beethoven. The one song that she was learning was for Elise. And Kristin loved to play, and she loved to wrestle. She's about the only one who could hold Sheldon down and get away with it. Those two did everything together, from playing video games to rollerblading to dreaming about what they were going to do in the world when they got older. Her best friend in the world was her brother Sheldon. This picture of me and Kristin, I don't know exactly what it was from, but she always said that her and me looked more like sisters, and that we were more like friends. It wasn't like I was her mom, I was her friend. She was my mini-me, so she was my extra set of hands. She was my extra help. And she was the best helper I had. I was just heartbroken and scared. Just scared the whole time. I felt scared because we didn't really know what she was facing.
Everyone was just devastated. Everyone really loves her because she was amazing, and people just cared for her and they wished and prayed that she got better soon.
But I felt that no matter what, that she would make it. And she always believed she would make it.
I had lost one of my best friends, and so had so many other people. We were all devastated. You don't really realize how much you actually would miss that person until they're gone. I wish she was here still.
I love you. Yeah, I would say I love you and I miss you. The Kristin Cares Club. Now that's something that was Kristin's dream from the time she was a little girl. She knew, I don't know how many kids know, but she knew from the age of six that she was going to travel the world and help people and animals as a humanitarian. It was her dream to start it, and we'd often talked about how to start it, what we could do to start it before she got older. And before she passed, we sat there talking about names, and we agreed upon Kristin Cares Club, spelt with K's. We liked, you know, her name was started with a K, so we thought that was kind of catchy and it would be, you know, a good name. So she really liked that name. We weren't sure exactly what we were going to do with it. We just knew that it was going to be something to help people and animals. And after she passed away, a lot of people really embraced that idea that she had. A lot of people really, they knew that she wanted to do that. They believed in it. And things just happened, you know. Within a month of her passing, I got a phone call from a father who kind of was the catalyst for it starting. He just said, "Hi, my name is Tony. I was wondering if you would mind if the Kids Chuck Wagon sponsors the club that you're starting for your daughter." And I couldn't believe it. I didn't know who he was. But I thought, wow, what a grand opportunity. And he had said to me, "You know, Pam, I don't know you, but if it would just bring a smile to your face, it will all be worth it." And I thought, wow, you know, there's things happening here. I don't know how they're happening, why they're happening, but I'm glad that they're happening. And once he gave us that opportunity, then it was, okay, now we need to do something. We wanted to do acts of kindness, little things that make a difference, because we're a little club. And a fellow that I know had gone on the Dreams Take Flight trip as a volunteer, and he had said that he noticed that the kids were more wanting to take something home for their families because their families were at home. And he said, you know, the one thing kids need when they go to Disney World or Land is their own set of ears to prove they were there. He said, "Pam, that's a place that the club could fill. You guys could donate them. We can do this. We can dedicate to doing this." So we did that, and that led to me being invited to volunteer. And then it led to us doing our next act of kindness and our next act. You know, we've done our three acts of kindness, but it's all been because of people caring and people wanting to help and people believing in what her dream was. So many people believe. They believed in her and they believe in her dream. And it's everyone along the way that's been helping to make it be reality. And always keeping in mind, what would Kristin think? What would Kristin do? With the vision of one too small to be heard, too young to be trapped in the way things were, not content with the way things were pre-planned for sure, who dared to follow a dream so much bigger than her. So put on your best, boys, and I'll wear my pearls. What I never did is done. A penny for my thoughts, oh no, I'll sell them for a dollar. They're worth so much more after I'm a goner. And maybe then you'll hear the words I've been singing. Funny when you're dead how people start listening.